In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. For the glory of God, let us join in singing, I am only woman, one day at a time, sweet Jesus.
One day at a time, sweet Jesus.
God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth. The glory of God, let us join in singing him, sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer.
Sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer that calls me from a world of care and bids me at my Father's throne make all my wants and wishes known in seasons of distress and grief. My soul has often found relief and oft escaped the tempter's net by thy return, sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer. The joys I feel, the bliss I share of those whose anxious spirit with such a hasten to the place where God my Savior shows his face, and gladly take my station there and wait for thee, sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer, thy wings shall my petitions bear to him whose truth and faithfulness engage the waiting soul to bless. And since he bids me seek his face, believe his word and trust his grace, I'll cast on him my every care and wait for thee, sweet hour of prayer.
We'll follow second order of worship, adoration of the Trinity. Second order of worship. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Glory be to you, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he who come in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, O God. Holy are you, O God. Holy are you, Almighty. Holy are you, Almighty. Holy are you, O Immortal. Holy are you, O Immortal. O Lord, our Redeemer, who was crucified for us, have mercy upon us. O Lord, our Redeemer, who was crucified for us, have mercy upon us. O Lord, Holy Spirit, have mercy upon us. O Lord, Holy Spirit, have mercy upon us. O Lord, accept our prayers and praises. Have mercy upon us. O Lord, have compassion and mercy upon us. Let us confess our sins. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves. The truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he who is faithful and just will forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. The time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news. For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but we have one who is in every respect has been tested as we are, yet without sin. Let us kneel and examine ourselves in silence. Let us humbly confess our sins to the Lord Almighty God. Let us say the prayer together. Almighty and most merciful God, we are strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and distress of our own heart. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we should have done, and we have done those things which we shouldn't have done. And there is no health in us. But you, O Lord, have mercy upon us, miserable offenders. Spare them, O God, who confess their faults. Restore them that are penitent according to your promises declared to humankind in Jesus Christ our Lord. And grant, O merciful God, for his sake, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, and just life. To the glory of your holy name. Amen.
Faith looks up to thee, the Lamb of God.
Almighty and merciful Lord, grant us pardon and remission for all our sins, time for amendment of life, and the grace and comfort of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us say the prayer together. O unchanging God, the God of all changes, who called the community of men and women to be participants in the kingdom experience, grant that the world would be humble enough to recognize the rights and dignity of women, the contribution of women in the making of history, and the role of women in the creation of the future, so that women would indeed be the agents of change and transformation. Through Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forevermore. Amen. Now we listen to the readings. First reading comes from Book of Numbers, chapter 27, verses from 1 to 11.
Today's Old Testament reading is taken from the Book of Numbers, chapter 27, verses 1 to 11. Chapter 27, verses 1 to 11. The daughters of Jelophehad, Mahai, Noah, Hogai, Milcah, and Tirzah were the daughters of Jelophehad, son of Hefer, son of Gilead, son of Machir, son of Manasseh, son of Joseph. They went and stood before Moses. Eleazar, the priest, the leaders, and the whole community at the entrance of the tent of the Lord's presence, and said, "Our father died in the wilderness without leaving any sons. He was not among the followers of Korah, who rebelled against the Lord. He died because of his own sin. Just because he had no sons, why should our father's name disappear from Israel? Give us property among our father's relatives." Moses presented their case to the Lord. And the Lord said to him, "What the daughters of Jelophehad request is right. Give them property among their father's relatives. Let his inheritance pass on to them. Tell the people of Israel that whenever a man dies without leaving a son, his daughter is to inherit his property. If he has no daughter, his brothers are to inherit it. If he has no brothers, his father's brothers are to inherit it. If he has no brothers or uncles, then his nearest relatives is to inherit it and hold it as his own property. The people of Israel are to observe this as a legal requirement, just as I, the Lord, have commanded you." Here ends the reading. Praise be to you, Christ.
Listen to the second reading from Book of Acts, chapter 16, verses 11 to 15.
The second reading on this Women's Sunday is taken from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 16, verses beginning to read 11 to 15. Lydia's conversion in Philippi. From Troas, we put out to sea and sailed straight to Samothrace, and the next day on to Neapolis. From there we traveled to Philippi, a Roman colony and the leading city of the district of Macedonia. And we stayed there several days. On the Sabbath, we went outside the city gate to the river, where we expected to find a place of prayer. We sat down and began to speak to the women who had gathered there. One of those listening was a woman named Lydia, a dealer in purple cloth from the city of Thyatira, who was a worshipper of God. The Lord opened her heart to respond to Paul's message. When she and the members of her household were baptized, she invited us to her home. "If you consider me a believer in the Lord," she said, come and stay at my house, and she persuaded us. Here ends the reading. Thanks be to thee, O Lord.
Thanks be to you, Christ. The glory of God, let us sing Him when we walk with the Lord. When we walk with the Lord in the light of His word, what a glory He sheds on our way. While we do His good will, He abides with us still, and with all who will trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Not a burden we bear, not a sorrow we share, but our song He doth richly repay. Not a grief or a loss, not a frown or a cross, but is blessed if we trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy but to trust and obey. But we never can prove the delights of His love until all on the altar we lay. For the favor He shows, for the joy He bestows, are for them who will trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Then in fellowship sweet, we will sit at His feet, or we'll walk by His side in the way. What He lays we will do, where He sends we will go. Never fear, only trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. We'll listen to the Gospel reading, Gospel according to St. John, chapter 4, verses from 27 to 30 and 39 to 42.
Today's Gospel reading is taken from John chapter 4 verses 27 to 30 and verses 39 to 42. At the moment Jesus' disciples returned, and they were greatly surprised to find Him talking with a woman. But none of them said to her, "What do you want?" or asked Him, "What are you talking with her?" Then the woman left her water jar, went back to the town, and said to the people there, "Come and see the man who told me everything I have ever done. Could he be the Messiah?" So they left the town and went to Jesus. Many of the Samaritans in that town believed in Jesus because the woman had said, He told me everything I have ever done. So when the Samaritans came to him, they begged him to stay with them, and Jesus stayed there 2 days. Many more believed because of his message, and they said to the woman, "We believe now, not because of what you said, but because we ourselves have heard him, and we know that he really is the Savior of the world." Here ends the reading.
Praise be to thee, O Christ. Preparation, let us sing, "Master, speak, thy servant hear." Let us pray. Let the words of my mouth, meditations of our hearts, be acceptable in thy sight, O Rock and our Redeemer. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Today we are celebrating Women's Sunday, a very prominent day in our life, because they are the change makers in families, in society, and in the church. And today's world never recognizes people who make changes, but on the other hand, it recognizes only the power and the status of people who destroy the very health of the society. So today the topic is women, the change makers. Change makers, the word, the concept is used by many international leadership programs, and they try to explain how the change comes in the society. Particularly in today's context, everything has to be changed. Everything has to be renewed so that the post-COVID situation may be a healthy and a prosperous time. Therefore, I would like to bring to your notice two important characters in the Bible, very important characters in the Bible, particularly from the New Testament and also from the same Gospel, John's Gospel. The first one, as we know, that Mother Mary. Mother Mary is the mother of the early church. Early church. She was the caretaker of the mother of the church, early church. And that's where Jesus on the cross, he handed over his mother to his beloved disciple John. And therefore John is the person who will explain things, who will tell things about women very strongly, and also he knows the context in which Jesus ministered with women, and also women participated in God's mission. Mother Mary is venerated in Catholic Church, and we take for historical reasons, but otherwise we never recognize and we never go deep into the responsibility she took to change the things. Therefore, I refer two important aspects of Mother Mary. The first one comes from the Gospel according to Luke, where the prayer of Mary. If you read prayer of Mary very carefully, that was during the time of Jesus' birth. If you read carefully, she never says that she is a saint. Though she was a responsible woman in this world, in the salvation history, she accepts her weakness. She accepts her human nature. Therefore, they are human at the same time, they are divine. And Mother Mary, she inaugurates the life of Jesus in a manger, in a very humble situation. And Mother Mary takes all the brunt of those days of women who are supposed to be the change makers of the day. And secondly, very importantly, Mother Mary appears in the same gospel. Gospel according to St. John chapter 4, where she is also takes the responsibility as mother, and in the wedding at Cana, she becomes more active. That was in chapter 2, I think. Yeah, chapter 2 of Saint John, where again mother becomes a person, an agent of change in that particular marriage situation. She was invited with Jesus and his disciples, and it's a family function. And there she goes. And the story we know very well, that there is a transformation of the water into a living water, or the wine, the blood. And the whole dramatized event of that marriage at Cana symbolically says that Jesus was invited. Jesus was invited by Mary to perform a sign, a greatest wonder of that day. And that was the first wonder of Jesus working on the natural things. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, she meets the wonders with Jesus in his birth, and secondly now, he is transforming the situation, and she invites Jesus, her son, to perform this great miracle. Therefore, it is not miracle, it is sign, the kingdom sign. She believed in the kingdom. That's according to chapter 2 of St. Luke, who writes the prayer of Mary. And she calls God as the Savior, Redeemer. She believed that her son is a Redeemer, he's a Messiah. And therefore, as a family member, as mother, she invites Jesus to this great sacrifice. And Jesus was very reluctant, and he didn't want to expose himself at that point. But with mother's call, she wants her son to perform that wonderful act, that sign of the kingdom during that time. Therefore, we can draw some spiritual themes from this whole episode of marriage at Cana. We just ignore other things. Here, Mother Mary, he is the character who changes the whole thing. And he is performing a sign. And the performing sign is calling Jesus to accept the blood, the wine, the great source of human life. And therefore, Mary is initiating this process of inviting Jesus to the cross. And she is giving this great call to Jesus to perform that particular event to meet the provisions of that family. And in the final chapters of Gospels, we find that the same Mary He is standing near the cross, under the cross. And she inaugurates the redeeming act of Lord Jesus Christ. And she is there to the end. And that is the Mother Mary. She began to occupy the position of the cross now. According to prophecies, she will see the wonders at the same time. She will have deep grief in her life, and crucifixion is also on her. It is not easy to watch children facing crucifixion and mothers standing before the cross. And here, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, she is making and she is invoking Jesus to perform unto this great sacrifice. She is calling Jesus. Therefore, wedding at Cana should not be taken as just a happy event, that is the inauguration of the cross and the crucifixion of Lord Jesus Christ. And here also we see water. Water plays a very important role. Water is for purification. The jars were filled with the ordinary water and it is transformed. The change comes. She is the change maker in a society where there was no salvation, where there was no redemption, where there was no forgiveness for sin. And here is a person who calls her son Jesus to do all this miracle, inaugurate all salvation act, all the redeeming act and all the forgiving act and the great sacrifice on the cross. And she is also calls Jesus to do a plentiful job. It also shows that in times we have a big harvest. Harvest of wine, harvest of food, harvest of the souls and harvest of fish. And here is a sign which calls Mary to request Jesus to perform this great act. Therefore it is a paradox that one side you have Jesus starting his ministry with this great event, wedding at Cana, and that also symbolizes his final banquet when we all meet as church, and from there Mary becomes mother of the early church. Mother of early church is not venerated like, but it is the fact, historical fact, that finally Mother Mary also accompanies John the disciple in his last journey and also the last visit to Greece, Patmos, according to the historical records. Secondly, the same John Gospel, he talks about Samaritan woman. The first one is the mother of the early church, who calls Jesus to become a sacrifice, a lamb, and also a redeemer, and also great salvation. In second, again Jesus meets this great woman called Samaritan woman, though her family life was not clear. Jesus knows this problem. And here is a person called Samaritan woman. Her name is not mentioned here. And she is the leader of that particular community to initiate Jesus as a redeemer. And he introduces this great prophet to this community. One side you have mother of the early church. On the other side, you have mother of a community which is oppressed. Who are Dalits, who are marginalized, who are poor, who are oppressed. Oppressed women, oppressed community, Samaritans. We know Samaritan's story. Samaritans were the victims of Assyrian war, and where they were taken to their lands as exiles. And their women were desecrated and they were spoiled in that their own native land. And there we find a community called Samaritans. And Jews and Gentiles And this Samaritan community has no link, social link, spiritual or any other religious. But they are the worshippers of same Yahweh in a place called Gerizim. Whereas Jews and Gentiles or the Samaritans, there was a big gap between these two. And they believed in Moses. Both the communities believed in Moses. They believed in the same Torah, the five books of the Bible, early books of the Bible. But spirituality was lacking with them because there was lack of understanding between this great Messiah who comes as the Redeemer of that community. And she becomes the mother of the redeemed community called Samaritans. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, the same water plays a major role in this event. When Jesus takes a dialogue between this woman and the kingdom values, she also expects this person to convert an ordinary Jacob well's water into a great living water. Mary has the same intention of changing the water, changing the community, changing the situation. Whereas Samaritan woman also expects Jesus to perform a miracle where the redeeming waters or the life water becomes the water for the communities for salvation. And she becomes the first missionary to transform her community. It was not an individual call by Jesus, or individually she is not inviting Jesus to convert every person in that community, because she called the whole community and she introduces this great master, the savior, the prophet. And he lives there for a short time and the whole community becomes a believer's community. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, one side you have Mother Mary, the mother of early church, other early persecuted congregation, Christians. Whereas here you have one more mother of a community which was totally rejected by all people, and they are the victims of war, they are victims of racism, they are victims of caste and other prejudice. In other words, the patriarchy was playing on them, on Mary, on Samaritan woman, on every woman at that time. And here are the two agents who can see the change through Jesus Christ. So Mother Mary, she tries to change the whole world, and therefore she is venerated, therefore she is honored, and she is the one who changes the society through church. And after that you see the church history, many orders came in the name of women, and today the global church, women make a big change in their society and also in their church. Secondly, we have a woman from Samaritan community. It was again a rejected community. And Jesus wants a particular person from that community who can play the role of change makers. And here is a person who comes to Jesus and inheriting the property of Jacob. That was the first reading we had today. And she says, we own your fathers, forefathers, spiritual water, and we also own their properties here in Sachar, that is Samaritan village. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, these two great change makers in church and society are the models today. And women today, we know they are the victims of this situation, and they are the change makers. Many women are not able to change their families, change their societies, change their environment. Whereas God brings two great models from John's gospel, and he is allowing these things to happen in our society. Therefore, let us commit our women into God's mighty hand. And let us pray for them. Let us sincerely accept that they are the change makers. Let us sincerely accept they are our mothers. They are our daughters. And they are our partners in life. Let God take control of our situation and make women the great change makers in our society and the church. Let us pray. God of Heavenly Father, we come to your throne of grace with deep gratitude and thanks, Lord, as we celebrate Women's Sunday. Your greatest models in the ministry, Mother Mary and the Samaritan woman. We glorify your name for making them to be the first mother and the mother of the downtrodden communities. And we praise and we give you thanks for the ministry throughout Christendom. And we also pray that your continued blessing, your continued spirit of changing the society will continue with our mothers, our sisters, our partners, and also our agents in society who are committed to this great task. Once again, Lord, we thank you for the words which we read, which we meditated. At this time, once again, Lord, we commit all our sisters and mothers into your mighty hand. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us stand and affirm our faith in Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father, Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into the dead. On the third day he rose again, he ascended to the heavens. Seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Friends, we have gone for a new sound mixing gadget, and it was the need of this time. The old one was already 12 years old, and then we had problem in communicating our programs. Therefore, yesterday we brought that gadget, and I thank Pastorate Committee and all the technical persons who installed this again for the ministry. And today we will have a dedication prayer for that, and we also pray for those who are in the hospitals. Families who are suffering, particularly we remember Benson, son of Mr. Dizzy Birajkar, who is undergoing a treatment right now. And I request you to please pray for this family in your family prayers. Let us pray. God of life, God of redemption, we come to your presence with deep gratitude and thanks. Lord, as we celebrate Women's Sunday, you are the Lord who is the change maker, and men and women become the instruments of your liberation act. Once again, Lord, we commit all our women in church and society into a mighty hand. Bless them, give them strength to understand your concerns, to establish your kingdom, and to make change in this world according to your will. Lord, we also commit those who are suffering in our church and also in the society. And we particularly remember Benson and stretch your healing hand upon him so that he will be renewed and he will be healed. Once again, Lord, we commit all our children, parents, and also mothers and sisters into a mighty hand. Bless them abundantly and make them the agents of change in their own family and in their own environment, their institutions. Particularly, we remember those who are celebrating their birthdays, those who are celebrating their wedding anniversaries. Lord, once again, we commit all of us into your mighty hand. Make us the change makers, and also to live for your glory, witnessing your redeeming act in the church and also in the society. We commit all of us into your mighty hand. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us say Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. A closing hymn is Standing on the Promises of Christ My King.
Standing on the promises of Christ my King, through eternal ages let his praises ring. Glory in the highest I will shout and sing, standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises of God my Savior. Standing, I am standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises that cannot fail. When the howling storms of doubt and fear assail, by the living word of God I shall prevail. Standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing, I am standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises I now can see, perfect present cleansing and the blood for me. Standing in the liberty when Christ makes free, standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing, I am standing on the promises of God.
May God, the giver of all grace, who has called you to share in the eternal glory through Christ, make you perfect, establish and strengthen you. Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.